Cap à présent sur notre deuxième sujet de cette
On our second headline lead this morning, a sensitive criminal case involving Ivory Coast and Burkina Faso. Now, the judiciary in Ouagadougou launched an international arrest warrant for François Compaoré, the younger brother of former President Blaise Compaoré, who lives in exile in Ivory Coast. François Compaoré, a key figure in the Compaoré regime, is now being accused of incitement to murder in connection with the investigation into the assassination and investigative journalist Norbert Zongo in 1998.
He has on several occasions been mentioned in the case, which was closed in 2006 without anyone being found guilty. Once François Compaoré is arrested, he will be taken to court and will immediately be charged with incitement to murder. 19 years after he was brutally murdered, there has been no progress in the case, though a previous decision issued in March 2014 by the African Court on Human and People's Rights ruled that Burkina Faso had failed to properly investigate the Zongo murder. It therefore ordered for the resumption of the investigations with a view to finding, charging, and trying the perpetrators of the murders of Norbert Zongo and his three companions. Judicial authorities have not yet provided the motive behind the assassination of Norbert Zongo, but it is popular knowledge that Zongo was investigating the death and the torture of David Ouedraogo, the driver of François Compaoré. Several soldiers of the former presidential security regiment have already been indicted and detained in the context of the judicial treatment of the case of Norbert Zongo. We are now joined by Benewende Sankara, one of the lawyers in the case. He joins us from Ouagadougou in Burkina Faso. Thanks for joining us on the program. It's been 3 months since the arrest warrant was issued against François Compaoré, and it is only last week that this information was disclosed. To what extent is this new development important for this case, which some believe has really lasted a long time now?
Le journaliste Norbert Zongo a été assassiné.
Now, the journalist Norbert Zongo was assassinated in 1998, and the motive behind his murder was that he was a very committed investigative journalist, was investigating the death of François Compaoré, the chauffeur. You have to realize that to issue an arrest warrant against François Compaoré almost 20 years later, for us defense attorneys, it is a victory, because for a while all eyes are on alleged culprit without proof. Now, thanks to the revolt that made Blaise Compaoré vacate his office, and between the 30th and the 31st of October 2014, documents were collected by the rebels and they were passed on to investigative judges and judicial authorities. Subsequently, it opened the case of Norbert Zongo.
Et ont permis justement aux juges d'instruction, aux autorités judiciaires, d'ouvrir.
Now, there are components that point towards François Compaoré.
Donc, il y a un faisceau d'éléments.
And I have to point out that there were three officers who were close to Blaise Compaoré, and since François Compaoré was a special advisor to him,
qui sont des militaires de la garde rapprochée.
The three officers are already charged, and I believe we have a solid case against the accused former leaders.
Considéré comme étant un conseil spécial du chef de l'État Blaise Compaoré, trois personnalités militaires là sont déjà inculpées, et moi je crois que nous avons une piste sérieuse vers bien sûr les responsabilités pénales.
Now, additionally, we have enough evidence that will give prosecution a lot of support against the accused.
And Benewende, we know that François Compaoré, as former President Blaise Compaoré, I mean, Blaise Compaoré is currently in Ivory Coast, and he obtained Ivorian nationality. And so do you think Ivorian authorities can collaborate in this case?
Je précise que la Côte d'Ivoire comme le Burkina Faso sont liés par des accords de coopération.
Now, Ivory Coast and Burkina Faso are bound by cooperation agreements. And according to the Ivorian law, it seems to me that an Ivorian national can be tried if the country does not want to extradite its citizen. Now, at the time of Noble Zongo's assassination that Francois Compaoré is accused of, he was not an Ivorian, and Ivory Coast must cooperate. Under the agreements of ECOWAS, the West African Economic Monetary Union, and the former COCAM, Ivory Coast and Burkina Faso have reciprocal agreements. And in view of all these agreements and all these treaties, Ivory Coast has no obligation but to cooperate.
This case had been closed and was only reopened following the ouster of Blaise Compaoré at the end of October 2014. 3 years down the line, have the investigations evolved, or are you satisfied with the direction the case is taking?
Well, I would say that justice is a reflection of the struggles that people face. And it is the people alone who are the sovereigns of their own justice systems. Now, Burkina Faso's justice system was harshly handled for a long time by the regime that was in place of Blaise Compaoré. He corrupted the justice system to even kill the case filed for Norbert Zongo. We even went to the African Court on Human and People's Rights in Arusha, Tanzania, which had condemned Burkina Faso during Compaoré's presidency, but we could not have any justice. Today, the progress of this case, Thomas Sankara and Dabe Bukari and others, which are political crimes, are unraveling positively because the authorities of our justice system decided to say that nothing will be as before and that the people are in control. That is why justice is a major player, a powerful point under the supervision of civil societies, human rights groups and lawyers, also political authorities, which is aware that it must guarantee this separation of powers. So it is true that major acts have been laid down, but as long as we have the display of truth, we will remain vigilant so that the criminals are hunted wherever they are.
A last question, Benewende. If there's anything that has to be improved in this case, what do you think it should be?
Well, myself, I believe that it should be to secure all the players in this trial who mediated this matter. We must give them especially their independence and the freedom necessary to go till the end of this case, because it is a trial with a pedagogical importance and that the Burkina Faso people want to show the world. Now, especially that journalists must be protected also in the exercise of their duty, because Norbert Zongo asked for one thing and one thing only, and nothing but the truth for a sinking democracy. Africans are thirsty for democracy, so impunity must be buried together with corruption.